Hello, my dear students. I know that you all are safe at your home, avoid going crowded places in the present situation. Now I am here to teach you one lesson from your supplementary reader, The Necklace, written by Guy de Maupassant. He was a French writer and remembered as a master of short story form. The theme of this story is importance of being satisfied with what one has. Listen. The Necklace, written by Guy de Maupassant. He was a French writer and remembered as a master of short story form. The theme of the story is the importance of being happy with what one has. Now move on to the important characters. Listen, first one, Matilda Loisel, the central character or protagonist in the story. She is a beautiful lady from middle class family. She is not happy with her middle class status. Second one, Monsieur Loisel, her husband. Monsieur Loisel, her husband. Third one, Madame Forrester, Matilda's wealthy friend. Madame Forrester, Matilda's wealthy friend. Important characters, Matilda Loisel, Monsieur Loisel, Madame Forrester. When you read the text, then you can see M. Forrester or G. Forrester. Listen. The story, to all of you listen here, the story took place in France several hundred years ago in France. This story took place several hundred years ago in France. Matilda Loisel lived in a flat with her husband. Matilda Loisel, the central character in the story, lived with her husband in a flat with her husband, who worked as a clerk for the Minister of Education. He was a clerk. He worked in the clerk for the Minister of Education. They are not luxurious, but they were not poor, merely simple. They were not luxurious, that means they were from a middle class family. Matilda, however, wished to be rich. Matilda, the central character, wished to be rich. She envied her friend, Madame Forrester, who has a large house and lots of jewelry. The Matilda Loisel envied with her friend Jean Forrester or Madame Forrester, who has a large house and lots of jewelry. One day her husband brought home an invitation to a ball. One day her husband brought an invitation letter for a ball. Ball here means a party. He thought his wife would be excited to attend such a fancy party, but instead she was upset. Then he thought that his wife became so happy when she got the invitation, but instead of what happened here, she was so excited. Why? She complained that she had nothing suitable to wear such an extravagant occasion. What happened to her? She complained that she has nothing suitable to wear to such an extravagant occasion. Her kind husband agreed to give her 400 francs to buy a new gown. The week of the party, Matilda seemed anxious again. The day of the party came, Matilda became anxious again. When her husband asked her why, she said that she had no jewelry to wear with her this dress. Then when her husband asked her, then she said that she had no jewelry to wear with the new dress. He suggested that perhaps she could borrow something from her friend Jean Forrester. Matilda goes to Jane's house and borrowed a sparkling diamond necklace. Then what did she do? She borrowed one necklace from her friend Madame Forrester or Jane Forrester. Borrowed a sparkling diamond necklace. She and her husband attended the gala and have a fabulous time. They went to the party and they attended the party. Finally, they reached home in the wee hours of the morning. They reached home after attending the party. They reached home in the morning. When they arrived home, Matilda realized that the necklace was missing. When they reached home, Matilda realized that the necklace was missing. Matilda, they searched everywhere but did not get. Matilda wrote to her friend that she broke the clasp and is having it repaired. Then Matilda informed her friend Madame Forrester that the necklace has broken. Then I will repair it and give it back soon. Madame Forrester agreed. In the meantime, they found another necklace that matches the missing one, but it costed 36,000 francs. They decided to buy a new necklace, but the cost of the necklace was 36,000 francs. Her husband fortunately inherited 18,000 francs from his father, but they will need to borrow the rest of the money. Fortunately, her husband got 18,000 francs from his father. They borrowed the rest of the money to buy the new necklace because the new necklace costed 36,000 francs. Finally, they have enough to purchase the replacement necklace, and Matilda gave it to Madame Forrester, who does not even look at it. Then at last they bought a new necklace and gave to her friend. Then what is the name of her friend? Madame Forrester. But she did not look at the necklace. The next 10 years, Matilda's life changed dramatically. They moved to a smaller apartment where she has to cook and clean for herself. Why? Because they took the money they got from their father. Then again, they borrowed the rest of the money for buying necklace. So, they moved to a smaller apartment where she had to cook and clean for herself. She also does work on the side while her husband works multiple jobs to pay back all the money they had borrowed. They worked hard to pay back the borrowed money. After 10 years, the money was all paid back, but Matilda had aged a great deal. Then after 10 years, they paid back the money, but Matilda has aged a great deal. One day, she saw Madame Forrester on the street. Then while she was walking through the road, she saw Madame Forrester on the street. She decided to tell her the truth about the necklace. Madame Forrester confesses that the necklace Matilda borrowed was a fake. Then Madame Forrester informed her that the necklace Matilda borrowed was a fake necklace made of paste worth not more than 500 francs. Then it costed only 500 francs. Clearly, the lesson of the story is that honesty is the best policy. And what is the moral of the story? Honesty is the best policy. If Matilda had been honest with her friend from the beginning, she would have learned that the necklace was not made of real diamonds and would not have wasted 10 years paying for a replacement. Then from this story, what we learn? Honesty is the best policy. If Matilda had been honest enough to say the truth to her friend, then she can definitely save her 10 years. Then here, she wasted her 10 years. So, from this story, we learned that honesty is the best policy. Then what is the theme of the story? The importance of being satisfied with what one has. Now, let's see once more. The necklace written by Guy de Maupassant. He was a French writer and remembered as a master of short story form. The theme of the story is the importance of being satisfied with what one has. The important characters are Matilda Loisel, a beautiful lady from a middle class family, but she is not happy with her middle class status. Next one, Monsieur Loisel, her husband. Madame Forrester, Matilda's wealthy friend. Then one day, Matilda's husband got an invitation to attend a ball. Then Matilda, after getting the invitation, Matilda became sad because she has no new dress. So her husband agreed that she was ready to buy a new dress for her. Then on the day of the party, again she became sad because she had no jewel to wear with the new dress. Then as per the direction given by her husband, she borrowed a necklace from her wealthy friend Madame Forrester. They went to the party, but when they came back, Matilda realized that the necklace was missing. They searched everywhere but did not get the necklace. They decided to buy a new necklace and to give her friend. Fortunately, her husband got 18,000 francs from his father, and the rest of the money they borrowed and bought a new necklace and gave to Jane Forrester or Madame Forrester. But later they moved to a small apartment because they borrowed money from their friends. After 10 years, they paid back all the money. But one day, Matilda met Madam Forrester, she decided to say the true story of the necklace to her. But Jane Forrester confessed that the necklace was a fake necklace. Then from the story, we learned that honesty is the best policy. What you learned from this story? The theme of this story is the importance of being satisfied with what one has. From this story, then we learned that be happy with what we have. Be happy with what we have. Then second point is honesty is the best policy. And third one is vanity is evil. That means that it may bring happiness for a short period of time, but ultimately it leads to ruin. It may bring happiness for a short period of time, but ultimately it leads to ruin. Then as in the case of Matilda, the protagonist of the story, then we have seen that she borrowed a diamond necklace to show her vanity. But she had to spend her valuable 10 years to pay back the amount. But at the end of the story, she knew that the necklace was a fake one. Then I think that all of you understand the story. All of you read the story. I will send you the notes through Google Classroom. Thank you all.